July 1st, 2019, I arrived in Australia for the first time in my life. This trip is meant to celebrate the 5th anniversary of a great adventure. This video is from 1969. Ian MacDonald and John Eggleston finished the human first crossing of the whole Australia continent by vehicle. We will finish this adventure with 5 Jeeps, 2 JK Wrangler, 1 brand new JL, 1 TJ, and another 1 JK8 with LS3 V8 engine swap. We were supposed to have another TJ, but unfortunately, it had some mechanic issues before we leave.
TJ 又坏了，还是刚才火花塞的问题。现在我们把火花塞拆出来，然后换新的火花塞看一下。刚才下高速的时候，TJ直接熄火。
But it turns out not because of the spark plugs. The engine was recently rebuilt, and the problems will come out from the engine block. So we decided to left it in Brisbane. We will start with the Brisbane, which is on the east coast of Australia. Traveling all the way to the west, crossing the Great Simpson Desert, and finally arrived at the most west point of Australia, Steep Point. For the Simpson Desert part, we will not follow in any trails. The paper maps and the campers will lead us to the west.
It's the sound of howling wind and driving rain, and heaven's on fire.
Met all the team members in Brisbane. The most amazing part of this team is that we will have two original members from 1969 expedition, 83 years old Ian MacDonald and 82 years old John Eggleston. Before we head out west, let me introduce one more member of the team, Dave Parkinson. We call him Emu because he named all his cars and the company Emu. Emu's Land Cruiser 79 series will be our backup vehicle to help us with the view in the middle of the desert.
We are going with us into the desert?
Yes. So today, I should be loaded in another half an hour or so.
Yep.
Going to take the trip leader.
Yep.
Out to pick some things up, and then we're ready to go. We've got 600 litres of unleaded fuel.
Okay.
My own fridge for drinks. I have to have a cold drink of an afternoon.
Yep.
Fire extinguishers.
Yep. Actually, I'm just wondering, what's the payload for this 79 series? Because you got 600 litres there.
Well, 600, I'm still within it. I'm about, it's about 3.8 3.6 ton.
Wow.
You know, so,
I had a chance to test drive it on our way to Burstville. This is my first time to drive a Land Cruiser 70 series, which is always one of my favorite Toyota. As you all know, it's really hard to have a chance to drive a 79 Land Cruiser in North America. Even when I get back to China, the majority of 70 series are gasoline models. Not like this one with 4.5 liter V8 turbocharged diesel engine. I usually don't have many chances to drive solid axle trucks on the highway, especially for the first time driving it on the right hand side with a standard transmission. To be honest, it feels so weird.
So when I hear someone say it, of course it makes sense to me. Good on you.
One of my biggest concerns before I came to Australia was the snakes. Emu shared us some stories about the poison snakes in the desert.
Yeah. See this one?
Yeah.
With the black head?
Yeah.
3 minutes, you're dead. If he bites you,
okay.
You must write, I love you, Mum.
Yeah.
Yeah. This one, oh. Bad. In the desert, you can see them. We have seen these ones. I've seen them.
Okay.
This one is a greeny colour, dangerous.
Yeah.
That one's okay, but they're all venomous.
They're all King in Brown. The desert.
Yeah, King Brown. Probably one of the worst. And they live out here in the desert. We've had eagles circling for half an hour when we stopped on one of the trails out here, and we wondered what he was doing. And then one of these, a Western Brown, come across the track under my car between the pair of us. So we sat still, and when he got about 5 meters away, the eagle just came down with a big whoosh, got the snake.
Hey.
So it was quite an experience.
Hey.
But for the snake, I'm pleased he's gone.
最后一百公里到Burstville，就是在辛普森沙漠边缘的最后一个小镇。接下来七天都没有信号了，所以今天要在小镇的一个有历史性的酒店住一晚上。今天晚上就是最后一晚上在城市文明。
昨天晚上住这酒店门口去停了一排，全是穿越车，两台七九，然后一台105，剩下全是尼桑的途乐。然后最让我吃惊的是，还有一台特斯拉。
I met the owner of the Tesla before we head out to the desert. Me and Sue Min interviewed the owner, and he shared us a story about his road trip with Tesla.
So we just ran into you this morning at the
yep.
Birdsville Motel.
Yes.
And Justin, he and I were fascinated that you are here in this Tesla.
Yes.
So tell us, you love your Tesla.
Absolutely.
And how many, you're from Melbourne.
I'm from Melbourne.
And how many miles did you drive it to get here?
To get here, approximately 2,400 kilometers. Sorry about the kilometers. Yeah. I got to say that, because I know where that might be going. Yeah. 2,500 kilometers, but up until the last leg, it was all on ordinary sealed roads with no issues. The last 388 kilometers is all on unsealed, a very bad road, and that's the Windora to Birdsville Road.
Yeah.
And I am limited in speed because the car cannot travel as it now is. It has to be on high suspension in order to clear
to
the
Windora,
to lift it up, which limits me to 50 kilometers an hour, which is about 30 miles an hour. So it took me 7.5 hours, Birdsville to Windora.
Well, we have a little trick that we use with our Jeep vehicles, and it's called a lift. So maybe you, and we use that with big tires. Maybe you could put big tires in a lift right on your Tesla. Yeah, but well, how do you like your Tesla?
It is fabulous. I've only owned a single car, the Tesla, since I took delivery in 4.5 years ago. I was the second delivered Tesla in Melbourne, and that was 4.5 years ago. I've done a total of 75 odd thousand kilometers around Australia. I do not use the car for commuting at all. It never goes out in Melbourne because I use public transport and walk in Melbourne. I live in central Melbourne. That 70 odd thousand kilometers have all been extensive trips across Australia, all of them.